how to bulk load media in Arctos. So bulk loading media in Arctos is a two-step process. The first step involves taking your media and transferring it to the TACC server. And the second step is then linking those media to Arctos records. So to start, if you've never used TACC before, the first thing you'll have to do is create an account. And you can navigate to portal.tacc.utexas.edu/account-request. And if you scroll to the bottom, click this button, you'll go ahead and populate fields to create a user profile at TACC. Once you've done that, follow the documentation on how to upload media to TACC. And you can find this in the handbook under Learn Arctos. Scroll down to this large batch upload section, and you'll see that once you've created that user profile, you will need to reach out to someone on the working group who can then link that profile to the Arctos Media project. And currently that person is Carla Cicero. Okay, so once you have all the background set up, you've got your TACC account and your TACC project allocation is live, you can go ahead and start transferring media. And you'll do that using CyberDuck. So let me drag that over. This is the window you'll see. And part of the setting up your user profile at TACC is creating that two-factor authentication. So make sure you do have your cell phone handy while doing this, but you'll click Open Connection, and that's going to pop up this window. And you can see mine already has some information populated. I highly recommend just creating a text file or Word document that you have saved on your desktop with all this information handy, so you can really just easily cut and paste all the information you need, since you probably won't be doing this super regularly. But do make sure you have your connection set to the SFTP. That's going to get us to the correct Corral server. Here's the path to that. I'll have my username and password, and then the path. And so this is going to be shared across Arctos users. And then, of course, this part of the path is going to be unique to your institution, your collection, and the project that you might be working on. So I'll click Connect. And it's authenticating. It's asking me for my token. And so I will be typing in the code. Okay, and so we've landed here, which is not actually my Arctos folders. This sometimes happens, I'm not sure why, but I'll just tell you how to navigate to Arctos in case you encounter the same thing. I will say sometimes you can have some luck by going to this drop-down menu and your file path may magically show up, but often you'll just have to go the long route. So you'll go to Corral, and then you'll go to Corral, Projects, Arctos, Web, and you'll see here are some of the institutions currently in there. So here's my UCM, this is the project I'm working on, and these are where I'll be transferring my files. And so now I am ready to do so. So I'll kind of shift that window over. All right, so these are the media folders I'll be dragging over. And we suggest actually just creating these dated folders as a way to house your media and help with quick retrieval. But you can do whatever makes sense for your organization. I'll grab the files I'd like to transfer and drag them over to my directory. And they're going. So here's my transfer progress. I'll be entering my code, 186139. And this window I keep having to drag over. So now you'll see my progress. And I do, if you're transferring a lot of files at once, it's best to just grab them all together, because if not, if you do one by one, you will be entering that token over and over again. Okay, so all of my files have now transferred. I can go ahead and look in any of these folders and confirm that yes, indeed, my JPEGs have arrived at TACC. And just a note, these media are technically available online at this point. So if you right-click on any of these, you can open URL and see the web address. So they're not super discoverable at this point, but they are live. And if you find that concerning, this is probably not the right media storage allocation that you need. So really anything under this web allocation is intended to be shared and available online. Whereas if you're hoping to store things like accession documentation or loan transactions, permits, or even high-resolution TIFFs, you can look into a private TACC storage allocation to meet those kind of needs. And so that's just a separate issue. And hopefully everything that you've transferred here is exactly where you want it. So let's move on to bulk loading media metadata. And that is how we will link all of these newly transferred images to the associated Arctos records. So let's go into Arctos, and to navigate to the media metadata bulk loader, you'll go to enter data, batch tools, media, bulk load media metadata, and that will take you to this screen. You'll click on load CSV, and this is where you can go ahead and grab a template, learn about all the fields in the bulk loader, the requirements, and link to documentation as well as code table values. And I'll just say there's another tutorial devoted to how to set up your bulk loader template, but I just want to show you a couple of things. So if we go into the spreadsheet I've just created, I wanted to point out the media URI. So you'll see here that path that we just saw at TACC. So this is going to be common to all Arctos media that are hanging out in the TACC server. And then of course, there'll be the second half of your path, which is going to be specific to your institution and collection and the folders that you've set up. So I'll just point that out. You can see all the various media fields one can add. But one tip I wanted to show you is if you are nervous about, you know, populating a giant spreadsheet with a lot of media file names, one easy tip to grab these file names from a folder. So if I go into my folder with my media, I can just select all of these, and then before right-clicking, I'm gonna push Control-Shift and then right-click, and then I will have the option to copy as a path. So if I just were to right-click on these without doing the Control-Shift, I wouldn't have that option. But again, if I do that, copy as path, and then if I go into a spreadsheet, let's just set up another page. I'm just going to paste that, and you'll see my entire path is now pasted line by line, and then I can go ahead and delete this information and find and replace and put in the TACC server web address. And so that's just a quick and dirty way to grab all that information without having to transcribe by hand. And thanks for watching this tutorial. Be sure to check out the Media Metadata Bulk Loader tutorial.